Now here the question is, if fx is convex on ab, then we need to prove that f a plus b by 2 is less than equal to 1 upon b minus a to b fx dx, and it'll be less than equal to f a plus f b by 2. Now in this question, what we are given is, we are given a convex function fx in the interval x equals a and x equals b. Now this is fa and this is fb. Now we join these two points, then equation of this straight line will be y minus fa fb minus fa upon b minus a into x minus a. Now if we look at fa plus b by 2, f a plus b by 2, it will be the value of this function at the midpoint a plus b by 2, and this value will be f a plus b by 2, and this integral from a to b fx dx upon b minus a, it is nothing but it is average value of this function in the interval a and b. Now from Jensen's inequality, for convex function we know that f a plus b by 2, it will always be less than or equal to f average value. So from here we can say, f a plus b by 2 will always be less than or equal to 1 upon b minus a integral a to b fx dx. Now we'll come to its second part. Now at any point x, y at x, it'll be greater than fx. So we can write fx will be less than fa plus fb minus fa upon b minus a into x minus a. Now we'll take this integral from a to b fx dx. We can write this integral from a to b fx dx, it will be less than or equal to, now it'll be f a into b minus a and plus f b minus f a upon b minus a, and here it'll be x minus a whole square by 2, it'll be b minus a whole square by 2. Now here b minus a and b minus a will cancel. So we can write this integral from a to b fx dx will be less than or equal to fa plus fb into b minus a by 2. Now we can rearrange it to write 1 upon b minus a to b fx dx will always be less than or equal to fa plus fb by 2. And this is how we prove this result. Now question number 7 is, this function f from 0 to infinite to r be a non-decreasing continuous function. So we have this non-decreasing continuous function f, and then in the region x, y and z, where x is greater than or equal to 0 but less than y, which is less than z. So we have three points x, y and z. So let this be x, let this be y, and let this be z. Now we need to prove this inequality, which is z minus x, this integral y to z fu du is greater than or equal to z minus y, this integral from x to z fu du. So what we'll do is, we'll find average value of this function in the interval xz, and this value will be given by this integral from x to z fu du upon z minus x. Now what we'll also do is, we'll find average value of this function in this interval from y to z, LB is integral from y to z fu du upon z minus y. Now we look at average value of the function in this interval fxz. We can write fxz, it will be average value in xy plus average value in yz divided by 2. Now, since it is an increasing function, fxy is always less than equal to fyz. So from here we can say fxz is always less than equal to fyz. Now, if we'll put the value of fxz, it'll be this integral from x to z fu du upon z minus x, it'll be less than equal to this integral from y to z fu du upon z minus y. Now we'll cross multiply, then we can write z minus y, this integral x to z fu du will be less than or equal to z minus x, this integral from y to z fu du. So z minus x fu du is greater than or equal to z minus y xz fu du. And this is how we prove such questions.